underground op, like, you guys, like, initially you had, you know, hostage life, bombs over Providence, protests, or all this, like, political, politically charged names. Like, did you go in initially with this kind of, like, hoping that it would be a political label? Like, is that what you wanted to accomplish from that? Or?
Yeah, I think to some degree it's still really personal political. I think, you know, very idealistic, being 19, 20, 21, wanting to change the world, wanting to make a difference, all that kind of stuff. And, you know, year 8, 10 years later, you sort of learn, I learned politics is about how you live your life, not about how you want other people to live their lives. So it's, you know, we make a lot of decisions based on a lot of the things we learned and experienced back then. So I think it helped us become who we are now as a company and as individuals in the company. And you know, we still, I love a band that can get out there and has something to say. There's nothing more inspiring than seeing someone, than seeing art that is out there to inspire, whether it be politically or just personally. So to me, politics, it's something more than just getting on band and saying, getting on stage in a band and saying, down with the government and that kind of shit. It's a personal thing for me. And I still stand by a lot of everything I used to talk about a lot more, and I used to be much more vocal about. Now it's just more personal.
How do you think the music industry has changed in the last 5 years? Like, what have you seen? What are the big differences?
A lot, drastically. It's incredibly different. It's turned into a real game of micromanagement, and that's putting a lot of pressure on the people working in the music business, I find. And it's, you know, you can trace it to the internet very vaguely, and say the internet really cracked it open. You know, before you had a website, you know, you did some street marketing, you went to radio, you went to video, but now it's like there's a zillion websites that you have to build your own page on, and there's a, well, I mean, just talking about the internet even, but then you look at how many bands there are with technology cracking music open, and there's so many more bands, and there's so many more records, and the competition is so thick. And even just to go out and tour, and there's so many more touring acts, to get people to come to your show is that much more difficult. And you have to promote that much more, and you have to micromanage all the little facets to get all the different people to come to your show and give you $5 to see you get on stage, or whatever a ticket might cost. So I think it's a lot more difficult for bands, and it's a lot more difficult for people working in the music business. But at the same time, it's really awesome because there's a million ways to break a band now. And every band can find their own path. And there's no one path that will work for every band. There's no secret, you know? You have to sort of do what you do and, you know, find your own way.
How do you feel like, I'm sure that there's an issue because you're with this independent label, but you're also an A&R rep at Universal, so there's that dichotomy of, like, you know, being independent versus a major label. How do you feel about that?
I don't know. I feel fine with it again. You know, I don't, if people think that's not cool, they can go themselves. I don't know. It's like music is, like I said, it's in this state of anarchy. It's like Protest the Hero, they're on Underground Operations, but Underground Operations is distributed through Universal Music. You can pick any indie label, like indie doesn't really even exist anymore, because all the indies are somehow tied to a major, because everyone's trying to figure out how can we get more records in stores, and how can we make our company stronger and give us the advantage, and you know, you could pick any indie label almost and figure out a way that it actually ties in to a major. The line between indie and major is so gray now that it's like, a label's just a label, and they're all having a really hard time selling records. And every label, from Sony to some indie label distributed through some indie distributor, which is secretly owned by a major label, because most of them are, they're having just as hard a time as Sony is, because it's not about anything but just finding good music. And whether you're the smallest label or the biggest label, if you find good music, you'll find success.